They were ninth in the Olympic Games in Calgary in 1988. They have been second in the World Championships each of the last 2 years. A very strong original program, Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler.
This is the best original program in the competition, and their opening move is spectacular. Required double twist lift. Look how high she is above his head. It is incredible. Now, if they're going to have a problem, it'll be right here, side-by-side double axles, and she falls on hers. That's a 0.4 deduction.
I would think then very difficult for them to overtake Beshke and Petrov.
That's a very costly mistake. Very costly. But the strength of the rest of the program could keep them in it. Very difficult pair combination spin here.
Again, the original program with 8 required elements. Isabel Brasseur stumbling on one of them.
Great unison on this pair combination spin here. Side by side. A very difficult lift. Backwards overhead to one-handed overhead to a flip out here.
One mistake. How costly will it be? Isabel Brasseur, Lloyd Eisler. They came into Albertville with a solid belief they could win the gold.
Here's another look at what makes them so spectacular. Look at the height and air position. It's incredible. Split double twist. He assists her into the air. Complete release move. She's completely above his head. Assists her to a perfect landing. Such a shame. Isabel just didn't get off the edge like she wanted to, didn't get the height she needed to complete the rotation, and could not hang on to that landing. She's a wonderful single skater, too. The problems that she's had with that double axel came after she heard a television commentator say that she is not a strong jumper, and ever since then, she's had confidence problems on it. And it wasn't me. It wasn't me.
That is her coach, José Picard, sitting to Isabel's right. Well, they're a wonderful couple. Again, required elements. Now, here are the scores.
And you can only imagine where those marks would have been had they not had to take 0.4 off for the fall and double axel. The German judge would have been 5-9, as would the Czechoslovakian judge. So a very costly mistake.
First off.
Any mistakes by the top teams can really open the door for any one of the other teams that is hoping or is sitting on the bubble for a medal.
And here are the marks for artistic impression.
And again, again, this really reflects the strength of the program. Wonderful choreography, end-to-end speed. A great original program, one mistake.
And they are both thinking what might have been. Right now, let's go down to Tracy Wilson, who's with a very disconsolate Isabel Brasseur.
Isabel, I know this is really disappointing. I've watched you do this jump over and over again and nail it all week. What happened tonight?
I have no idea what happened because it's been 3 weeks that I haven't fallen on this jump, on the music at all. So I guess it's just bad luck and we'll just have to get up and just go out there and do what we can do Tuesday.
Taking another look at Isabel's fall, it looked like she just didn't get her free leg through enough to get the height she needed to complete the rotations. There's no way you can complete the jump when you're still rotating on the way down.
Isabel was consoled by her parents backstage, but that couldn't stop the tears. The world champions, Natalia Mishkutonok and Artur Dmitriev.
Special for American television.
I think he's learned what the red light means.
We have your official Olympic credentials. You have your official United States Olympic Committee credentials. You have your official, in case you get lost, credentials.
Rocky Marvel seems fully accredited. Well, he and his partner, Kala Urbanski, have received a lot of publicity recently. Here's Tracy Wilson.
Since winning the U.S. Nationals, Kala Urbanski and Rocky Marvel have been bombarded by attention from the media and from well-wishers. It's been absolutely nonstop. But the problem is, when you're training for the Olympics and you're doing interviews and making appearances, sometimes you get caught up in the hype and you lose your perspective. Remember, when they left Philadelphia, they said they wanted to finish in the top five. Well, now it seems that anything out of a medal would be a disappointment. Up until now, they've been thriving on all of the attention. They're skating great. But today, the bubble burst. They spent the day together, sharing in their traditional good luck pasta lunch, and Kala's emotions seemed to get the better of her. Tonight, they're going to have to put those emotions and the pressure aside. We'll see if they can find the psychological balance to get the job done.